Starting your class with a mindful approach allows you to set up a focused and mind-on way of thinking in your classroom. You will have more success with classroom management, as well as the students will be more focused. Remember, transitions between classrooms from one room to another is often difficult for many students. I know that I am talking to teachers of all grade groups when I say this, and that means that some of you, I know that are teaching very short classes, and some of you have half-hour classes, some of you have hour classes, some of them are 45 minutes. That being said, all classes are different, and I want you to think about how you can make this work in your classroom. I teach mindfulness because we need to teach the whole student and not just the subject. This is how I start my art class, to create a mindful atmosphere and to create a successful learning session. You might be wondering, what is mindfulness? Well, mindfulness is like an approach to being aware of oneself, understanding and looking inward to understand our body, to understand our mind, to be aware of the present moment, what we're feeling right now, not worrying about the future, not worrying about the past. We're just focusing on the present moment, and we're understanding our thoughts and feelings and how all of it's interacting in our bodies. So it's like a form of meditation in a way, but it also becomes, it allows you to be calm, it allows you to be peaceful, and allows you to really just focus yourself. And that is very helpful when one is trying to be learning, of course, because we're trying to understand what's going on in our brain, understand our thoughts and ideas, and being mindful and getting into a mindful thinking allows us to, and will allow your students to really be aware of their thoughts and ideas in their head, so they can work more fluidly and get into the artist zone. So, to create this mindful, calm atmosphere at the start of your class, you can first turn down your lights, dim them, turn off some of them, turn on lamps if you have them. See, for me, I always turn off the lights and then I turn on my lamps. I got my lamps at a local thrift store. Of course, they might not match your classroom theme if you have one, so don't be like worried about that. Just get a lamp. And of course, you can use your artistic skills to decorate that lamp. You could spray paint it, you can go crafty on that lamp, or if you paint it like a rainbow, I mean, dude, that will do wonders for your classroom. Next, I have calming music on in my classroom for the students. I find zen, relaxing, or calming music on Spotify or YouTube, and then I play it, because usually those playlists last for hours, even though I don't need that amount of time. So I ask them to get into their spots, take out their sketchbooks, the calming music's on, the kids become quiet because this is a not talking time. The calming music is on because nothing brings more joy than calm and zen music. You can put on cafe music or coffee shop music, Hawaiian music. All of these things bring happiness and get us into the art zone. Students are now expected to draw quietly or sketch for 5 to 10 minutes. And this will vary depending, again, on the length of your overall class. So at the beginning of this video, I said, I am aware that all classes are of different lengths, but I highly encourage you to find an appropriate amount of time that works for your classroom schedule to make this happen. So give them around 5 to 10 minutes, put on a timer. I ask my students that they do not talk in this time. And I say, as they all get their sketchbooks open and they settle and I see that kids pick up their pencil, I walk around, I remind them that this is your time to be mindful, to be a mindful artist. And a mindful artist is someone who looks inward, they focus on their breathing, and they slow it down, taking deep breaths in, deep breaths out. And then I do that a few times, deep breaths in, deep breaths out. we should be blowing out as though we're pushing through a straw to slow down our breathing. And now we're going to focus on the moment. We're not worrying about the past. We're not going to worry about what's happening in the future because it hasn't happened yet. We don't need to worry about it. We're just going to focus on the moment now. And of course, I talk in my calm voice, kind of like I'm doing right now, because I need to model and give the atmosphere that this is a different time. This is not me in my teacher voice. This is me in my calm voice. So I say, look inward, and we're going to think about our thoughts. We're going to think about what our brain is thinking. We're going to think about what we're feeling right now and how it's affecting our thoughts, why we're feeling that way, why our body's acting this way. We're going to think about all the things that are happening in our body and be very aware in the moment. And we're going to feel calm and peaceful as we breathe in and breathe out. And you're going to do this as they do it. And then you can become quiet once they are settled and drawing. So I also give them choice of what they want to draw with. So they can draw with pencils, they can draw with crayons, wax crayons, felt markers, whatever is easy to use and is available and is easy to put away within those 5 and 10 minutes. And then your job in this, after you've done, you've got the whole classroom in that mindful zone, you're gonna walk around, you can whisper hi, whisper hi to kids, you can welcome them to your classroom, say nothing but just smile. This also gives you time to transition from another classroom. So transitioning from one class to another is very hard for students. Giving them a mindful time will give them time to transition their brain from whatever they were just doing and worrying about into your classroom. So mindful experience, it allows them to remove the thoughts from what just happened, slowly get into a new calm space, and they can open up their brain and hearts into being an artist. Okay, that also gives you the time to transition into teaching a different class, because I know that you guys have very little time between classes, because I have very little time between classes. And some of the teachers could come late, some teachers don't pick up in time, and so then you get frazzled, and this will help you feel less frazzled and stressed out, and it will help your kids feel less frazzled and stressed out, and we'll all be mindful together. If you have older students, you may want to ask them to write a quote down in their sketchbook for the day that they're drawing on. So usually what I will do for older students is I will write an inspirational quote or an artist quote on my whiteboard. And they are to record that quote somewhere on the paper or page that they're using that day, either on their blank paper or if it's in their sketchbook, they will record that on their sketchbook page. So usually I'll Google and search for quotes that are either inspirational quotes, motivational quotes, quotes about creativity, quotes about experimenting or making mistakes, quotes from artists that either we're working with or that I like. So you might find an Andy Warhol quote or whoever, a Pollock, I don't know. Find a quote that you want to share. Usually I will print off pages full of just quotes, so that way they're all in those like clear plastic sleeves in the front of my day plan. I just have to quickly pick one and then write it on my board, and then I use a dry erase marker and cross it off, and then on the plastic sleeve part, not on the actual paper, so I know I used it. And then when I have a different class, I can just wipe it off, right? So that's a good way to also kind of inspire and get kids thinking in a mindful way. After the timer goes off, you're going to quietly ask them to finish up their last lines and put their pencils down and show that they're ready to listen for the lesson. Now it's time to bring back that teacher voice, and you can put back on your loud voice and ask kids, all right, today's lesson is... By starting the day mindfully, you are turning off whatever happened in your students' worlds before they got to your class, and you're going to set it up to allow them to achieve in your own classroom. You're going to create a mindful set of thinking and an art mindset. You're going to upload the art brain and get rid of whatever drama happened or other, you know, gym class, remove all that for the time being. Not only is this a mindful strategy, not only is it good for their art practice, but this is also going to make you feel happier, it's going to make them feel happier, and it's very good for the emotional and mental well-being of your students. Remember, we need to teach the whole student, not just the subject. Whatever length your class is, I hope that you've tried to incorporate this mindful thinking strategy in the start of your classes. Try it for a while and just see what happens. As well, you can totally tweak it to suit your own teaching style. I would love to know how you start your art classes. Leave your response in the comment section below the video, and we can have a discussion as art teachers all together. As well, it'll also give you a chance to be a comment star in my future videos. Like this video and click the bell to receive notifications when new episodes arrive. As well, please subscribe to this Artastic channel. For more art tutorials, please head on over to my blog at msartastic.com and check out my art resources in my Teachers Pay Teachers store. For more behind the scenes footage and ideas for your classroom, please follow me on Instagram at msartastic. Of course, all these links are clickable in the comments section below, so head on over there and check out what's available for you. See you next time.